Hi everyone. So today I wanted to kind of get another makeup tutorial up, but I wanted to get it up early enough just in time so that you guys could really get these looks together. So this is going to be my Valentine's Day makeup tutorial of 2017. And these types of tutorials make me just so excited. Even if I'm really not doing anything on Valentine's Day, just getting ready and making myself feel so much better is just so important to me. So if you are spending your Valentine's Day alone or with someone else, I feel like this is a look that you could totally do just to boost your spirits up anyways. So if this video interests you, just keep watching. Okay, so I have already primed my face, I've already moisturized, I've already done everything that I needed to do before applying makeup. So I just wanted to give a little disclaimer here that my skin has been going through something awful the past week and a half or so. As you can see really close up, I have some really horrible acne issues going on. My cheeks are very, very red, so I do know exactly what caused that. Every single time I consume oil in my diet, I just break out so, so bad. Normally though, if I don't have any oil, I never get breakouts. So that is just how it is right now, so bear with me. Also, this is a little bit of a different background today, just because I am filming early enough to get some natural lighting in here. And as I've said before, natural lighting is definitely the best lighting. So that is why you are seeing this background, which is my entire room. So I am going to start today with priming my eyes with the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion, the original formula. So I just take it and I just put it on my eyes, like so. And this is just gonna help your eyeshadow stay on all day. And I even put it up a little bit on my crease because I have a little bit of veiny, I literally can't even think of this name right now. I have veiny eyelids, so yeah, I like to cover them up. So then I literally just blend it in with my finger. I don't use any brush for this or anything. Your finger will be perfectly fine, I promise you. So I just blend it in with my finger. And again, you don't need a lot of this product. It's not so much for coverage, it's more of for keeping your eyeshadow on. And because it is sticky, it's going to just stick to the eyeshadow that you apply on top of it. So that is the point of an eyeshadow primer. Next, I am going to start with my eyes. Now, the theme to this look is going to be a lot of pink and purplish and mauve-y shades. Mostly pink for Valentine's Day. It's going to be something new that I normally would never do. So we will see how this turns out. I'm going to start with my Morphe palette. This one is 35T palette. And it looks like this. As you can see, it has a lot of pink and purples and mauve-y shades in it with a few neutrals. So that is what we will be using today. I am also going to go in with my Sigma E38 Blending Crease Brush. Now, how I like to start is with the transition shade. This is kind of going to make your eyeshadow blend together seamlessly, flawlessly. So that's what I'm going to apply first. You're always going to want to apply matte shades to your crease and as your transition color. You don't really want any shimmery shades up here other than if you're doing a brow bone highlight. So, that being said, for my transition shade today, I am going to go in with this shade right here. It is a light brown shade and it's going to be perfect for the transition. Don't mind me, I am going to be using my mirror in this video also. So if you see me looking down, that's why. I can already tell that this transition shade is going to be perfect for this look. I just blend. While I'm doing this, pay attention to the motions that I'm doing. because that is very important. You want to do quick circular motions on your eye to make it blend seamlessly. Do the same thing on this eye. And I feel like I have mentioned in my other makeup tutorial that looking down at yourself in the mirror like this is how you get that flawless line between your brow bone and the rest of your eye makeup. Like that. You have to look up at yourself to really see that. Now that that's all blended out, I'm gonna go in with a crease shade. And for my crease shade, I want this to be, this is gonna be kind of an intense Valentine's Day look for if you're going out at night on a date or even if you're just staying in, but you want to get glam by yourself because that's all you need. Morphe M412 brush, which has a point at the end of it, which is perfect for precision in the crease. I'm going to go in with this shade right here. It's a darker purple shade, like so. And I'll apply a little bit more, focusing the majority of the heaviest part on the outer corner, but not exactly on the outer corner, just near it. On the outer crease, I should say. I'm gonna put another shade in my outer corner, that's why I say not in, fully in the outer corner, and then I'm just gonna do the same thing on the other eye. A little bit more. The thing that you want to concentrate on here is not applying too much to your brush at once. You don't want it to be extremely harsh. You want to keep blending to the point where you get the perfect amount of product on your eye. So for the outer corner of the eye, I'm gonna go in with this dark purple shade right here. It's a matte purple shade, very, very, very matte, and that's what you want on the outer eye. Very light hand, very light hand. Do you see how strong that came out already? You have to be very, very careful with the outer corner. And I'm just gonna form a little triangle. It's okay if it's messy, but that's what we're gonna do for now. You see that? Of course, it's gonna look messy at first. You're gonna blend all this out later on, but you just wanna get that shape, almost like a little eyeshadow wing going on there. And a little bit on your lid, the outer corner. Just when there's nothing, barely anything left on your brush, you're just gonna bring it in to blend everything all together. And you'll see in a little while me blend all this together. I'm not gonna do it right now. Okay, so I'm gonna do the same thing on this eye. So I'm gonna take that dark purple shade that I just took on the outer corner and do the same thing on here. Like I said, have a very light hand at first, because it will come out very, very, very strong at first. I usually start with the heaviest part of the product on my outer lid, and then I'll work my way out. I'm just gonna apply a little bit more. Slowly but surely. Don't let messiness deter you from trying something new in makeup, ever, because it will look bad at first. It looks bad on everyone at first. You just have to blend, blend, blend. And it doesn't mean that you need to blend that very second either. If you're feeling overwhelmed at all, just skip on to another part of your makeup and go back to it later. And I promise you everything will be fine. So that's good enough for now. I'm gonna leave that as is right now, even though it looks crazy. I'm gonna go in with my Tarte eyeshadow brush. It has no number on it, but it did come in a holiday kit. And I'm going to go in with a shimmery shade on my lid. The key with shimmery shades is you want to go in with a matte shade underneath that is of similar color. This way, it'll look a lot more pigmented. So I'm going to go in with this shade right here. It's definitely more pink than purple. So I'm going to start with that because I want my lid to be pink and shiny. So I'll go in with that. As you can see, the difference, definitely pink, right? And I'm gonna apply a little bit more of that. Mind you, I never ever wear pink eyeshadow. Like, the only time you will probably ever see me wearing pink eyeshadow is on Valentine's Day. So now is when we're gonna go in with our shimmery shade. And for that, I am going to go in with this very shimmery pink shade right here. So that's what we're gonna go in with. And I'm gonna do it on the lid. Very pretty shade. See how it gives kind of just a little bit of a pop? Apply a little bit more of that on there. Now you want to focus this only on the lid. You do not want to get it in the crease at all. Now comes the blending. So I'm using my Sigma E38 brush again, which is just a regular crease brush. Okay. And we're going to blend this all together. And mind you, this is all going to look so much better when you have your face makeup on and your face done. Trust me. I'm going to take my RCMA No Color Powder and this Sigma F64 brush that I use for my setting powder. I use it to set my face. And I'm going to take my brush, dip it in, tap off the excess, and put it under my eye like so. Like that. Now, you can do this before you do your eyeshadow, or you can do it after, it doesn't really matter. I probably should have done it before because I think that would have been a lot easier. And we're just gonna keep it there for a little while. Okay, so it has been about 2 minutes and I'm just gonna go ahead and wipe it away with my brush. So I would definitely recommend doing this before you apply the eyeshadow. So when I apply my concealer, I am going to fix that even more. So it was my bad for not doing that before I applied my eyeshadow. So now I am going to go in with the Nars Radiant Creamy Concealer in the shade Mustard. No. The Nars Radiant Creamy Concealer in the shade Custard. This is my favorite concealer of all time. So I'm just gonna take it and apply it underneath my eyes and basically under all of my problem areas. Just like this. This is a brand new one. I just bought it. I use it up like you would not believe. And we'll do the other side. And this is where my pimple is. Which is really cute. What should we name it, guys? What should we name my pimple? Because it's so friggin' beast that it has to have a name. This is where we are going to fix our eyeshadow. I bring it up here also, just for that reason. So I'm just gonna put this down and I'm going to reach for my Tarte concealer brush, which definitely needs to be cleaned so desperately. It's actually disgusting. So I will be cleaning that this week. But we are going to just blend all this into the skin. We're not going to drag it, we're just gonna use patting motions. This is really going to get it into the skin. Mind you, I did not film this part, but I did already moisturize and prime my skin before this so that your pores will be protected. So I'm just gonna do this. This is where I'm going to fix my eyeshadow. Okay. Now it's precise. See that? It's so easy. I'm gonna bring it down on the cheeks because I have some acne issues going on, obviously. And I'm going to make this eyeshadow more precise on this side also. See how much more precise that is? Yes. That is what we want. It's getting dark here. The sun is going down, so I hope the lighting isn't bad. Okay, so now that everything is pretty much all blended, we are going to move on to our foundation. I am going to go in with my Tarte foundation brush. It came in that holiday kit with that eyeshadow brush also. And I'm going to go in with my new foundation, which is the Tarte Amazonian Clay Foundation. I don't know if you can see that. It is cruelty-free and vegan. And what I do is I take my finger and I just dot it on my face. This really controls how much product you're using, and that's what I love about the tip of it. You just squeeze it instead of a pump, where it's a little bit harder to control how much you're applying. And I'm just gonna blend it in with my brush. Like so. Try to avoid getting it in your hair. Just gives a very flawless coverage. One comment I will say about this foundation is that it definitely gives a white cast in pictures. Definitely. I am almost the fairest shade in every single line. I am the second fairest shade. So, not the lowest shade, but I'm extremely fair right now. Welcome to the winter of Massachusetts. So I'm gonna take my RCMA No Color Powder again, and I'm just going to set my under eyes and everywhere I concealed. This is just gonna keep your makeup on all day. All day. Nothing will move. It's crazy. I swear by this powder. Bring it down on my cheeks. Just just make sure you tap off the excess, guys, because a lot of product comes out at once. The packaging of the RCMA No Color Powder is outrageously dumb. RCMA, get better packaging, for real. Okay, I'm just gonna wipe it away because I don't wanna bake my under eyes. And the good thing about this powder is that it kind of brightens your under eye. So this is great to use in the morning if you're absolutely exhausted. No one would know. I am now going to go in with my eyeliner. I'm using the Kat Von D Tattoo Liner in the shade Trooper. It is a felt tip liner, and I have to say that I am definitely not used to them. So I start in the outer corner where I'm gonna do my wing. Sorry, I had to go ahead and move my setup because it was just getting too dark and the lighting just wasn't working. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply my eyeliner now. Now, please mind me if I'm out of the frame. It is extremely, extremely hard to film eyeliner on camera. You do need two hands. I'm gonna start at the outer corner and make a wing. Like so. And then I just work my way in. Make the wing a little bit thicker and then just flick it out. Okay, so that pretty much is how my eyeliner is going to look for right now. The best I can do. Now I'm going to move on to bronzer. And today I'm going to go in with the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer. It is cruelty-free and vegan, which is awesome. And looks like that. So it's definitely a darker shade, but it blends out beautifully. It just blends in perfectly with your skin tone. So I would highly, highly recommend this bronzer. Going to go in with my Real Techniques blush brush right here. I'm just gonna go in with that. I'm gonna buff that on my face. Like so, and on my forehead. It's just gonna bronze up the face a little bit, because like I said, I'm extremely pale. And God, do I need bronzer. And on the chin, to even out the cheeks. And on the jawline. We're gonna bring it down the neck. And now we're going to move on to the blush. For today, I'm gonna go in with Colourpop's birthday suit, which unfortunately is not vegan. It is cruelty-free, but it's not vegan. So I do just wanna use it up. I've already hit pan on it, so it is almost gone. But I thought that this is a great shade for Valentine's Day. It would match. Sure, it would match with the eyeshadow, and I just thought that it would be really good for the cheeks. So I'm gonna go in with the Wet n Wild blush brush, which is my favorite blush brush of all time. And I'm just gonna go in. You're gonna have to pat your brush in a lot because the Colourpop blush formula is extremely different from all the rest. It's actually creamy. So I'm gonna go in the cheeks with it, and see that barely anything applies on the cheeks. It's a very strange formula. And it just gives a little bit of a pretty pinky tone. Perfect. Now, I don't do a lot of blush, so that is good for me. Next, we are going to go in with the brows. I'm going to take my Anastasia Brow Wiz in the shade Soft Brown, and I'm gonna go ahead and apply this to my brows to shape them. Okay, that does it for the brows, and now I'm gonna go with the Benefit Brow Gel, and I'm just gonna set this all over my eyebrows. This is not cruelty-free or vegan, but it's almost gone, so you won't see me using it pretty soon. So the brows are done. Again, I like the natural look of brows. I don't like very carved out and shaped brows. And now I'm going to go in with mascara. My Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara, of course. It's my favorite of all time. You want to make sure you get the top and the bottom of the lash. Before I do the bottom lashes, I'm going to go in with my eyeliner for my waterline. I'm going to go in with the Marc Jacobs Highliner Gel Crayon in blacquer, sorry. And I happen to love it. Unfortunately, it is not cruelty-free or vegan though. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in with my bottom mascara. And when that happens, don't touch it. So I'm gonna let this dry, because everyone loves when that happens. In the meantime, I'm gonna go in with my highlighter, since I will not be applying it here. I'm gonna use this Physician's Formula Miami Strip Healthy Glow Bronzer. Clearly this is not bronzer, this is a highlight package. They are called Shimmer Strips, and they're in the shade Miami Strip. I think it is safe for me to take this off my face right now. Okay, that came off my face nice and easily. And I'm gonna go in with this pinkish shade up here. I'm gonna try to concentrate my Tarte highlighting brush in this pinky shade. I'm just gonna apply that to the cheeks. And that's pretty perfect for this look. Right above the arch of the brow and down. That's how I apply highlighter.
center of the chin only, not anywhere near my pimple. Upper lip. This is the perfect highlight shade for this look. You want to go with pink highlighter for Valentine's Day, I think, or a white one with a little bit of a pink undertone. That would be the best thing for Valentine's Day. So last but not least, I'm gonna go in with my lipstick because I used pinks and purples. I'm gonna go in with this lip shade called Dopey. It's their Colourpop's Ultra Satin Lip. Okay, and this is the final look. I really hope that you enjoyed it. I actually really like the way it came out. Here's a close-up of my eyes. And I think it's just such a romantic look. You can curl your hair, you can do whatever you want. You can wear something really dressy or something with flowers, totally up to you. I wore this shirt because that's really all I have right now. So thank you guys so much for watching. I really enjoyed doing this tutorial for you. There will be more to come, obviously, but I thought I would get one up a fair amount of time before Valentine's Day, just so you have time to see what types of products you would like to go out and get or what types of shades you would want to use so that you can go out and grab something if you don't already have it. So thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you in my next video. Bye.